Let's continue with the fifth chapter from your political science book of grade 12, and the name of the chapter is Franchise and Representation. And today we are going to start from minority representation, meaning and rationale. So how relevant it is, we are going to understand that minority representative concept is. So democracy is a system of governance in which people's power is supreme. The government is representative of the people. It is essential that the system of representation should be such as can enable both the majority and minority communities to elect their representatives. For ensuring representation to minorities, several scholars strongly advocated some special steps for minority representation. The concept of minority representation stands for ensuring representation of minorities along with the representation of the majority community. While some advocates of minority representation hold that minorities should be given representation in proportion of their strength in the society, some others support the case for giving some representation on to them. For the former is known as the proportional representation of all the people. So what is rational importance of minority representation? So although a liberal democracy, democratic state always grants equal civil, social, political, educational, cultural and political rights to all the citizens without any discrimination of caste, creed, religion, ethnicity, birth, gender, there is always accepted to need to provide some additional measures for protections to the rights and freedoms of the people belonging to minority community because of their small numbers. So while granting equal rights and freedom to all the citizens, the Constitution of India provides special protections to the educational and cultural rights for the minorities. Article 29 and Article 30 of Part 3 of Indian Constitution define the educational and cultural rights to the minorities as the rights of the citizens. So Article 29 of Indian Constitution grants the minorities a right to maintain their representative respective language, script and culture. Article 30 grants to the minorities of rights to establish the administration and administer their educational institute. So we can say that further the Indian Constitution makes some special attempts to ensure some representation of minorities in all representative institutions. What is proportional representation? Proportional representation is a method of minority representation which is designed to ensure the representation of minorities in a rough proportion and to their numerical strength. It advocates that only those candidates should be considered elected who are in the position to get a fixed and definite quota of votes. Quota here means number of votes, and not just more votes than other candidates. It also tries to ensure that only one member or one number or that only a minimum number of votes may be wasted. So there are two types of proportional representation they're talking about. One is the single transferable vote method or the Hare system, and the second one is the list method or the list system. So what is single transferable vote? Single transferable vote system means to the creation of multi-member constituency involves the election of 3 to 15 representation of one constituency. Grant a single vote to every voter, one vote system. Okay, the system indicates of his preferences along with the cast of his vote by the voter. In it, the voter, while casting the vote in favor of a candidate of his choice, also indicates his second, third and fourth or than other preferences in other candidates. Okay, so as you can see the list here, if a candidate is going to cast the vote, he is saying Mohan is his first choice, number one, and Krishna is his second choice, third is his, Shyam is his third choice. Like this, he is kind of, or he or she is casting, the voter is casting the vote according to his choices. Okay, and the vote kind counting will be done. For winning an election, a candidate has to secure a fixed number of quota of votes. Okay, which are calculated. So total number of valid votes polled divided by number of seats to be filled plus one. Okay, and there we are going to get a certain amount of number. So that is going to be the minimum. Okay, that is going to be the minimum votes which a candidate needs to secure. This is one type of you can see it is getting transferred. If the vote counting is done and found that Mohan being the first preferences, Mohan have not been able to succeed, then his entire vote, then the second choice of those candidates will be considered. Okay, next is the list method. List method means each party can give number of members. So suppose in the first constituency, each party have given suppose four, you can see that four members. And the next also four members. The second list, in the listed form, they are giving the name of their participants, or you can say name of the candidates. Okay, and then the voter is just giving the vote. So if one party gets 27% popular votes, it gets 27% seats. And if some party gets 30% vote, that person will get 30 seats. So like that, they are keeping on calculating. Okay, they are also having a minimum vote that they have to, the quota have to get fulfilled, and then they can, and the percentage which they are securing, according to that, the political party will get the seat in the constituency. And not only that, and if one political party is getting in one constituency less number of votes, and in second they are getting more number of votes, that will get transferred from the second constituency to the first constituency. There are a few merits, okay, like it gives due responsibility, gives a due representation to all section of the society, okay, fully democratic, minimum votes are wasted, encourage to minorities, okay, majority cannot become dictator, source of more public education, more respect for the legislature, helpful for securing national integrity, suitable for multi-party system, benefit of multi-member constituency, and so on. There are a few demerits also. Can lead to huge legislature because number of members are going to increase. Weak government, problem of government making because so many candidates will be there. More party politics will be there, a complex system. Okay, the vote counting will be really very complex. Okay, and there are a few more problems. For that, I'll say this type of, though having merits, and also it is having demerits also. Yes, next they are talking about some methods of minority representatives. There are the six methods discussed here. One is the secret ballot system. Each voter gets single vote. There are created at a single member constituencies, and a candidate can win an election only when he gets at least 51%. That is a clear and absolute majority of votes. In case is in an election, no candidate gets 51 votes, the candidate with the lowest number of votes is declared defeated. Okay, next, number two, cumulative vote system. Each voter is given some as many votes as is the number of representatives, so which are to be elected, and each voter has the freedom either to give all his votes to any one candidate or to distribute his votes among as many candidates as he wishes. So each voter is given as many votes as the number of representatives. So if there are 10 representatives or 10 candidates, then we will say that each voter will get 10 votes. Okay, each voter will get 10 votes. And that person can cast vote to different persons, or it can give the 10 votes to one single candidate. Okay, limited vote system. Each voter is given several votes, but decidedly one or two votes less than the number of representatives. Again, if there are 10 representatives, the voters will get 9 votes or 8 votes. Okay. Number 4. Communal electorate system. The electorate is divided community wise, and each group of electorate gets the right to elect a fixed number of representatives. In this way, each community, big or small, gets the representation. However, this is an unhealthy and harmful method. It destroys the society and social unity of the people and treat them as separate communities. Okay, reservation of seats. Under this system, some seats are reserved for the minorities, in the sense that only persons belonging to minorities can contest elections. And so for the reserved seats, that is the constituencies. Okay, this is followed in India. Nomination of representatives of minorities. This is again followed in India. Under this system, usually the head of the state is given the right to nominate some representatives of the minority community to the legislature of the state. As for example, the president of India has the right to nominate two representatives of the Anglo-Indian community in the Lok Sabha. So political party and party system. Political parties are extra constitutional structures. Without political parties, elections cannot be held. Government making cannot be efficiently pursued. So political systems are considered democratic only when the people will have the right to organize the political parties, and only when in reality at least two parties are involved in the struggle of power. So what is the meaning or definition of political party? So we can say political party can be defined as an organized group of citizens who participate in election process and determines, participates in the election process and thinks of winning the election and rule the country by capturing the state power. Okay, so they want to rule the state, and this political party have to participate in the election process, then only it will become a political party. Okay, if they are not participating in election process, that means that is not a political party. A fair large group of people. Okay, a fairly large group of people performs, and they dare to form a political organization. Okay, it consists of several groups of people, young and old, rich, men, women. Okay, lots of common things can be among them to form a political party. Okay, agreement on the basis of principle. All the members try to agree on the same principle, and they try to follow the same methodology, and they have certain goal to achieve certain goals. Okay, next they are saying about organization. So all the political parties are organized. Okay, they have organized themselves. They are having some objectives, some policies, some they are having some organizational structure. Okay, like somebody will be the president, somebody the secretariat, like that they have organized themselves. Okay, a faith in peace. Faith in peaceful and constitutional means. That means they are participating in election, and they are following the constitutional way, peaceful way, and they are coming through ballot. They are coming through ballot process in the power, and not through bullet process. Okay, they have to participate in the election process, and then they will come to the power. Okay, promotion of national interest, active participation of policies, politics. Okay, essential of democracy Democratic political party. A political party which is democratically constituted have five other important characteristics. First, with the broad spectrum of ideological unity, it tolerates, permits, and accepts the existence of internal groups as active party of the whole. Right, so the second is all democratic political parties accept each other as competition parties in the struggle of power. Okay, together they constitute the political system. Not only one single party can constitute, okay, so it is a political system. Next, they are saying party system. Thirdly, every political party is a democratic of a democratic state plays its role in politics as mandatory by the people of elections. Fourth, each political party stands committed to uphold the national interest and the democratic system. Next, finally, a democratic party has a democratic structure and it functions in a democratic way. It is democratic in its organization and behavior. So in a totalitarian or authoritarian state, the ruling party is an instrument for the exercise of power by the authority or totalitarian ruler or a group of people, while the political party system are democratic. The Communist Party of China is also an undemocratic, centralized, single party exercising all the powers of political Chinese political system. So if we just sum it up, we can say that a party system is a distinct or separate group, okay, of people actively and peacefully participating in the political process for the promotion of national interest.